Hello and welcome. Suppose I have the function f of x equals the cosine of x divided by x squared. Clearly now I have a function that's composed of the quotient of two different functions of x. So I'm going to let cosine x is equal to the u of x, so the numerator function equal the u of x, and I'm going to let v of x, the denominator function, equal x squared. And because I have the quotient of two functions, to differentiate f of x, I'm going to have to use the quotient rule. The quotient rule is defined as the differential of f is equal to v, the bottom function untouched, multiplied by the differential of the top function u, minus u, the top function untouched, multiplied by the differential of the bottom function, all over v squared. So in my case, u is equal to cos x, or the cosine of x, and u differentiates to negative of the sine of x. V is equal to x squared, and this differentiates to 2x. So putting this together into the quotient rule, I get the differential of f is equal to v, which is x squared, multiplied by the differential of u, negative sine 2x, minus u, which is cos x, multiplied by the differential of v, which is 2x, all over v squared, so x squared squared. So now tidying up this expression a little bit, I get negative x squared sine x minus 2x cos x all over x to the power of 4, as I can expand this index into the parentheses, and I can factor out a negative x here in this expression too. So if I write this as negative x outside of x sine x plus 2 cos x, I can then cancel out an x with the x on the x to the power of 4 on the bottom. So an x and an x will cancel out here, leaving me with, if I write on the next line, leaving me with negative outside of, well, a negative 1 really, but I don't have to write the 1, negative outside of x sine of x plus 2 cos x all over x to the power of 3. And that's all there is to using quotient rule. Please give me a thumbs up if you have found this video helpful. If you are currently studying math, please feel free to subscribe to my channel for future videos that may help you on exams or assignments. And as always, please feel free to ask me any question by commenting on any of the videos that you've seen. Thanks for watching, and I hope you've learned something.